here's the two brushes side by side. So the top brush is the long round 8, and then the bottom brush is the round 8 Aqua Elite. So basically similar brushes, right? But the top one has a longer, a pointier end. So that's what serves as a smaller brush. So overall, like, I can paint the whole bird with that regular round brush, but then I can use the pointy part of the long round 8 to paint like the more pointy areas, so like the beak. So right now, I am painting the beak with that pointy part of the brush. So I'm grabbing the paint with the tip of my brush, and I'm using that as I was painting, let's say, with a smaller round 2 or 0 brush. So I'm also holding the brush by the end of it so I have more control. It will be more like random stroke for more even looser strokes. But right now I want to focus more on the face around the eye of this bird. So I do want to take advantage of this end of this brush. So the pointy part, so it's like almost like painting with a smaller brush. And in this case, I'm just mixing colors as I go. So I'm just blending them. I'm not blending these colors on my palette. I'm just kind of letting them blend on the paper. So just bringing different colors. But I can go back and forth with this brush from one area to the other, and I can take advantage of the fact that this brush can hold a lot of the paint and water, but I am actually working with the end of that brush. So what you can do is grab as much as you want to with the majority of the head of it, and then just focus on using just the pointy part. So you bring in all that onto the paper, and then you can also pull the paint with the tip of that brush, like right now. So now I'm adding a little more of that color, and I'm pulling it and adding a little more color and some of the browns and painting some of that feather. So that's the thing with this brush. I can do a lot of work with just this brush, painting all that feather and just using that tip of it and spreading the paint, letting it all blend different colors. And of course, what helps a lot is having a sketch, that's for sure. But you can definitely paint birds without any sketch as well. Again, painting with the tip of the brush mostly, but grabbing the paint with majority of it. You can also lift up with this brush. So you would dip your brush in water, wipe it on a towel, and then go with that wet brush, but it's wiped before on a towel so it doesn't have that much water, and then go over the areas, and you can lift up either wet on wet or once the area is almost dry or it's completely dry. So now I'm really close to that eye, so I want to really be careful there, and it's a small area, so I definitely want to keep an eye on what I'm doing with this brush. And I often twist this brush from one side to the other just so I get to that pointiest part, working on that eye. So this is where I'm just using that tip of it. Here I am switching to the regular round 8. So this is the thing, like, it doesn't have that longer end, but it's still pointy enough that I could work on smaller details. So it's just a matter of preference, but also you can paint with both brushes, and this one helps you to bring in a little more in a way, and the other one works as a smaller brush at the same time. So with this round 8, regular round 8, I'm painting the entire tree branch, and now I'm adding some of that hair, a little more feathers, and bringing more fullness into the body of this bird, and just take advantage also of the shape of this brush and paint some of those claws. Just smaller areas are okay too, because this brush overall, it has a nice point. So even it's not extended, so it doesn't have that length, it still has that nice point. And you can still do a lot of it with just this brush. Even it's such a small area, I can still use that end of the brush, and it works just as well. It just depends how much you want to use of each brush. The advantage of the long round 8 is that it also can work as a rigger brush because it's longer. So a lot of times I can paint that longer hair, not just on birds like the feathers, but also whenever I paint cats or dogs, I can use that long round 8 to paint that hair. So not just the feathers. So both brushes have different benefits of using them. It's just a matter of preference and what you're painting. Thank you so much for watching.